of City Impact. It's our full life disaster response team. We've been sent out by Samaritan's Purse. In a neighborhood called Wood Manor in Tuscaloosa, 7 days after an F5 tornado came through. The structure you're seeing in the background here is a church. It was destroyed. Turn around and give you an idea of the perspective. We're actually here with students from the University of Alabama, some local residents. We're at Sam and Judy's home. We're here, again, with City Impact Samaritan's Purse, quite literally removing a tree from their swimming pool. The work order said tree removal. We did some yesterday. This is a whole different order. We're draining their pool. Level of devastation here is hard to understand. The video doesn't do it justice. But in the middle of it, opportunities to be the hands and feet of Jesus and share the love of Christ. What we found above the rubble. Stuck up there by some work crews. Flying proudly over the city of Tuscaloosa. Roll Tide. Part of the reason we have choppers circling is because we have looters. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, that are coming out in the broad daylight masquerading as work crews. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. So just had some drama. Here's the main pile by Sam and Judy's house, and if you'll see these gentlemen, these are National Guard and Tuscaloosa Police Department. We had to call them in because there were some guys who came in wearing Samaritan's Purse t-shirts, pulled a van up and started pulling scrap metal out of these people's homes out of all the wreckage. So, thank you very much. So we had to go get the police and come down, and they ran these guys out. So sin loves an opportunity, doesn't it? Okay, so you think that she's sitting here just taking it easy. Your name, young lady?
Chapel.
This is Chapel. She worked with us yesterday in the rain. This is Clay. I didn't want you to see him. Hi, Clay. But Chapel has a reason she's sitting here. 4 weeks ago, well, that. So she didn't tangle with a shark. What happened 4 weeks ago?
I had three vascular tumors on the back of my leg.
So, tumors removed. A couple weeks later, she's out here removing brush and debris. And it's all because she's a University of Alabama student. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Again, out at Judy and Sam's place. We've been here about an hour and a half now, and I showed you earlier what the pool looked like. Well, here's what we've been able to do in about an hour and a half. To give you some perspective, the experts say that being able to help people, even in small ways, where they can walk their property, cleaning out a path so that they can actually get around and look at their materials and survey the damage, all of that is helpful in, on the path to getting a sense of normalcy again. A crew's been going through the rubble back here, some other volunteers. We found a series of family heirlooms intact. Very encouraging for the family. And again, small steps, small things found help them regain a sense of emotional balance so they can start to deal with the incredible trauma of all this. Hey Jamie, let me try this again. So this is Jamie, our fearless leader. He's a 13-year resident of Tuscaloosa.
Yeah,
so
I'm a darn Yankee. This is the second take. I didn't make the mistake of wearing my Samaritan's first shirt.
So Jamie loves Tuscaloosa. You're originally from?
Lockport, New York. Tuscaloosa is my home. My roots go deep here now. And the tornado was supposed to hit my house dead on, and it jogged south. And I figure I've got to get back to the community since I was spared. And I'm retired from GM, so I've got the time to go with it. And I'm here for the long haul.
Excellent. Thank you, Jamie.
Thank you.
So when we arrived at Samaritan's Purse, we were assigned to Jamie's team. So, this is Akeem.
Hey,
say hello.
What's up?
Akeem and Hunter.
What's up, man?
A couple of our University of Alabama students, they went home for the semester. They were here during the storm, went home, and came back to help. So, a little different from what we were dealing with yesterday, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Amazing stuff. So, all the UA students are making this just an amazing experience.
Well, thank you. Roll Tide.
Students.
Woo-hoo.
All right.
Roll Tide.
These two ladies are with us yesterday, but your name is?
Sarah.
This is Sarah. And again, they all were out of school because of the tornado, and many of our UA students came back just to help. So, way different experience than yesterday, isn't it?
Yeah,
a lot worse. Yeah, so amazing. Thank you, ladies. City Impact goes to places all over the globe. But there's something about being on the ground and watching how they coordinate with other organizations and with the community for us as a local church up in the Charlotte area, 8 hours away, City Impact made it possible for us to be on the ground very quickly. It's exactly 1 week to the day from this F5 tornado that came through Tuscaloosa, one of the worst in U.S. history. And thanks to City Impact and Samaritan's Purse, we were able to actually do something. So thank you to all of our guys back home that gave financially and are praying for us to support us while we're out here. But thank you to City Impact and J.D. Smith in particular, and Samaritan's Purse and all that they do day in and day out to help people deal with this kind of devastation. And in the middle of it, to talk about Jesus. It's the real thing.